Let's go to Sam Armstrong, Director of Communications at the Henry Jackson Society. Good evening, Sam. Can you hear me?
Evening, Kev.
Hi, Sam. Well, you got the gist of that, that the High Court, the law courts, have decided that you can. It's not unlawful to block the Queen's Highway if you're protesting. Now, what I suspect is they've decided that in terms of climate change protesters, because they're nice and middle class. If you're anti-vaxxers or anti-lockdowners, don't expect the same leniency. But they're overturning more and more convictions for blocking the Queen's Highway by convictions of Extinction Rebellion protesters. So in effect, when you see them blocking up the bridges, they did London Bridge today, Tower Bridge yesterday, causing absolute mayhem. These people, they basically know there's no recrimination. They're doing this with impunity. What kind of a system is that? No wonder the coppers are just standing there looking at them.
Yeah, no, that's right. And in fact, the Extinction Rebellion lot have got lawyers that just tell them exactly this. And they say, look, there's no point us coming in there and helping you out. There's no point you telling the police anything. Just keep your mouth shut. They'll process you, they'll book you, and they'll send you soon back in again. It's a little bit like the club bouncer who decides that, no, we're not going to bar people anymore. Actually, if someone's misbehaving, we'll kick them out tonight. And, if they want to come back tomorrow, they'll come back tomorrow. And then they get the same troublemakers in the pub again and again and again and again and again. They get worse and worse. They go from scrapping around to throwing glasses to kicking down the door, and before they know it, the bar's getting shut down because no one wants to come because it's deeply miserable. And that's the situation the police have boxed themselves into.
Yeah, and to be fair to the police, they've been boxed into this by a legal decision by the High Court, which was reached because the Crown Prosecution Service did not challenge this decision. They didn't offer any defence of prosecuting people for blocking the Queen's Highway if they're protesting. So the Crown Prosecution effectively accepted that there's no crime if you block the Queen's Highway if you're protesting. Well, I would say that's ludicrous, because, you know, I'll accept that if a bunch of demonstrators form a march and they walk down the street, that's fair enough, that's traditional, and they're on the move. But what these Extinction Rebellion dancers and singers and middle-class people do is they just occupy the bridge. They just stand there, and they should be moved by the police and then prosecuted.
Yeah, well, what you have, Kev, I'm afraid the Crown Prosecution Service is probably the most left-wing organisation in Britain. Just look back at who's in charge of it. You've got Max Hill. He was the chap who used to be the independent reviewer of terrorism legislation, who famously met with a group called CAGE, who were the same people who'd called Jihadi John a beautiful young man. He was known as a sort of terrorist sympathiser. Then you had Alison Saunders. Now, she was the worst director of public prosecutions in history. Not my words. Those are the Times of London. They ruled that. And then before that, who did you have? Keir Starmer. If you want to know what kind of organisation it is, it literally was led by the current leader of the Labour Party. This is not a neutral government body. This is a left-wing organisation funding and promoting left-wing London lawyer liberal lefty values. And that's what it's doing.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. It's almost as if they're in cahoots with Extinction Rebellion. But as I say, there has to be, Sam, a deterrent for people who decide to sit down and block the Queen's Highway. Other people want to use these roads to go about their lawful business, to earn a living, to get home, to get to work. You cannot have the police just standing there saying, well, there's nothing we can do.
Yeah, and look, the trouble with not dealing with them is they're only going to go and get madder. I mean, today, of all the people in the earth that they could have protested against, who were Extinction Rebellion protesting? I'll tell you. It was the World Wildlife Fund. Yes, that same World Wildlife Fund that's saving the pandas. This is the eco-animal group that has done more to preserve nature than any other organisation I can ever recall. Why were they protesting?
Yeah, tell me, please explain.
because the World Wildlife Fund have some nature reserves around the world. They buy the nature reserves, and what they do is they move people out of them and they give that land over to nature so nature can preserve. But they, according to Extinction Rebellion, there are indigenous communities in Tanzania and elsewhere that are getting moved along. And that was colonialism, neocolonialism. So they were going to go protest the World Wildlife Fund. What on earth? This is a group that is trying to save the environment. In the process of so doing, they're having to move local people on. As we know, there's a big problem of poaching in Africa, preserving this space. And what does Extinction Rebellion do? It protests against them. As I've said before, Kev, and I'll say it again, Extinction Rebellion couldn't give a hoot about the environment. They just hate this country. They hate what we stand for, and they're trying to tear us down. That's the only logical explanation.
They were sort of protesting around talk radio towers today, and I saw them coming up the street. They were just like a load of sort of medieval lute players playing flutes and banging tambourines. A more middle class spectacle, Sam, I've never seen in my life. They really are the tweeest bunch in the world, and you know, but they should be arrested. There should be a deterrent, because they're all nice people from nice areas like Tunbridge Wells, and they don't like criminal records, and we should give them criminal records. I'll tell you what, this country gets madder by the day. Sam, always a pleasure to talk. Thanks, mate. Sam Armstrong, Director of Communications at the Henry Jackson Society. I'm Kevin O'Sullivan, and this is Talk Radio.